Forwarding the interest of Awesome in the Universe $1,000 at a time. That's the goal of the Awesome Foundation. Since its creation in Boston during the summer of 2009, 85 chapters have sprung up in 19 countries around the globe, and it has funded, no strings attached, 2,200 community projects to the tune of $2.2 million. Joining us to discuss the efforts, some of the local projects they funded, and how you can participate is Natalia Martinez-Kalinina, founder of Awesome Miami. Natalia, welcome to Issues.
Thank you for having me.
Let me rattle off, if I could, just some efforts you've helped. A Miami Beach designer who creates ball dolls for childhood cancer patients. Busker Fest, which is a street music festival in Miami. And actual frames on string between two trees that make a sailboat on a mooring off Miami Beach look like art. Tell me about your favorite projects.
So I think it's really hard to pin down just one project, because the idea is that we fund very different and disparate things in the community. And so kind of if I really have to pick some, I'm going to pick two examples that are really disparate to kind of showcase that how, the diversity of the things that we fund. There was one project called Pretty in Little Haiti, and it was the proposal was essentially to create trash cans or makeshift trash cans in an area of Little Haiti that didn't seem to have enough kind of trash cans provided by the city. And so the proposal was to take refurbished oil gallons or kind of barrels and to partner with local Haitian artists to decorate them and so to beautify them and make them interesting and pretty and appealing. And then, you know, you get trash cans on the street, but that only really solves one part of the problem. And so there was a secondary piece of it, because you can have a trash can. If it's not an actual county trash can, it won't be picked up. And so the idea was then to partner with local businesses who would each be responsible for the cleaning and maintenance of each of these trash cans. And so what I love about this project, it was an ordinary person who noticed something in their community that they felt strongly about, and that they had an idea that they felt empowered enough to fund. And it was extremely grassroots. The entire project was done for $1,000, because they kind of put together a lot of different strings. And so that's a project that I really love. Another very brief example that's completely the opposite is we had an application once from a PhD graduate and his partner, and they were doing a research project around testing water and liquids. And normally liquid testing can be pretty onerous and cost prohibitive. And so they had developed an analog testing device that tested a liquid for one parameter. So you could test water for a particular contaminant or blood for a particular metric. And so their idea was that this would be, if this actually worked, it would be a resource for low-income communities as well as emergency situations. And they had done one successful pilot, and they were looking for $1,000 to contribute to their second pilot. We frankly did not understand most of what this presentation was about. But it seemed awesome and interesting and whimsical, so we gave them $1,000 to run this pilot. I checked in with him a couple of months after that, I think probably 6 or 7 months after, and they had closed a round of funding for $800,000 based on that successful second pilot, and they had their own lab that they were running to kind of further work on this project and turn it into an actual solution.
Wow. So let's talk about common threads. On your website, you detail what the projects are judged on. Can you tell me more about that?
Yeah, so generally, I mean, we don't have a particular criteria in terms of things that we won't be excited to consider. In general, we do tend to focus on things that have an impact, so that's important to us. Impact is defined very broadly. It can be, you know, a neighborhood block, it can be a larger part of the city, a particular population, a subset, a school. So really, impact is a broad definition, but we want your project to have a consideration for someone essentially other than yourself.
And these are $1,000 grants. The board essentially pays for it.
Correct.
They pay dues, essentially.
It's self-funded.
And I noticed that you make a big emphasis on not a lot of paperwork. They get the money, you don't have to report back.
Right.
Is there a lesson in philanthropy in general for that?
Well, so we feel so. I mean, I think once you're applying for much larger grants and once you're kind of engaging with larger institutions, there are merits and there are reasons for having a much more robust process for selection and follow-up. When, you know, for us, the idea is to engage the average person and to create those individual, personal, micro pivot points around the city and the county. And so we don't want to make that a very difficult and onerous process. The entire application is 4 questions. They're very short. It's no strings attached. So we will follow up, but you don't have to, you know, we're following up because we're hoping that you're doing well and we want to see how to support you, not because you owe us a report or a detailed document or some kind of verification of how you use the funds.
4 questions. Mm-hmm. That must be the shortest grant application around.
We sure hope so.
That's fantastic. And so have you learned anything about Miami in general from this?
I would say so. I mean, people often ask me, I relocated here from New York 4 years ago, and my friends in the Northeast, where I lived for a decade, always ask me kind of what keeps me in Miami and what makes me optimistic about a city that is undergoing so much change and visible change. And I frankly answer that Awesome Foundation does, because it lets me have visibility on a monthly basis into the tiniest corners of our city and the most average corners of our city, where you find that people care.
Perfect. Natalia Martinez-Kalinina, thanks for being with us today and sharing the work of the Awesome Foundation and Awesome Miami.